When kids ask you, like, what's a puppet? Do you have like your own definition?
Right. Yes, that I ask them actually, and I'm always interested in their answers, and we sort of edge towards the definition, and then I usually say, well, this is my job to know this. So I have a pretty broad definition. I say it's the animation of an inanimate object in front of an audience, and that's it. So for me, I would say that anything that's inanimate can be a puppet. I'd say robots are puppets because they still have they have programmer. You're not moving a string or a stick or something, but you're programming an inanimate object, and so the programmer is the puppeteer. I would even say that a statue that has sort of a latent tendency to move, like something that looks like it's on the brink of moving, or you move it in your imagination, I think that could even be a puppet too. So I have a fairly broad, like I'll just, everything can be a puppet.
I like it.
And I think we, I think it also works because everything is animated at an atomic level, like those little atoms are bouncing around, and so it is animating there. It's a bit of a mind twisting, bending thing. Usually what I say to kids is, you have to put the audience into that equation though, because you've done your own little private puppet shows probably, like when your computer's crashed and you blame it, or you go out and kick your tires because your car's broken down, and you are animating, and it's a human tendency to animate something, to make sense of it, right? But it's also a theater form, so you do need to have an audience. Otherwise, it's just a private puppet show.
Yeah, I like this definition, and it's make people react like.